So I was a little bit calm with my 25-11 for worst of 2022. Not no more. Expect a lot of emotions with this video. Trigger warning. So I don't know if that trigger warning is for me or you to be offended about what these 10 are going to be. But let's just say there's a good chance you guys didn't see any of these 10, which congratulations for you for staying away from these type of films. But you know what? I love Pain and Misery. So let me tell you what the Pain and Misery was. And number 10 is probably going to be on a lot of people's top 10. Bros. I'm sorry. This is a movie that was so unfunny, so unoriginal. The story was basically like, oh, I want to butt fuck a dude there. I'm going to jerk some guy off and spit on your dick. Oh, I'm going to do an orgy here. Oh, I have life so hard. And it's just like, it's a pity party bullshit movie. I fucking hated it. And the total resolve of the movie is like, okay, maybe we could date for 3 months and maybe we'll be okay partners. Really? That's what took you fucking this long to realize? Like, you guys were going out for that long and all of a sudden your shake hand deal is like, oh, I'm proposing to be a dating partner for 3 months? Like, oh my God. Like, this is fucking atrocious. Billy Eichner is not a funny person whatsoever. It was pretentious. It was overbearing. It was horrible. They spent $40 to $50 million on this film. Where the fuck did that budget go? Universal, that budget, bro, that was $50 million. That was $50 million. What the fuck? Where did it go? Seriously. The only funny gag was basically Jodie Foster being a chandelier on the building. Other than that, it was like, what am I laughing at? Okay, that's gay sex. Cool, bro. Oh, more gay sex. Cool, bro. Oh, gay orgy. Cool, bro. What's funny? I don't see the fucking humor. Number 9 was a Peacock movie called Mid-Century. Oh my God. Atrocious acting. Atrocious writing. Atrocious everything except the production design. When I said the production design was pretty cool, yeah, some of these houses were pretty awesome. But some of this dialogue was like, at least, like, it was like, I hated this dialogue. Maybe doctors are like this, but when a cop is basically saying, ma'am, can you please help me with an investigation? And you go, you mean doctor? And everything this woman says, it was just like, I wanted to gag and just like choke her out. I wanted to choke her out because everything was just so bad in this film. This movie, like I said, writing was horrible. Buzzwords on the internet, Twitter buzzwords, oh, what are the buzzwords of 2022? Oh, yeah, this is so original. No, it's not original when everyone fucking does it. When it's done by fucking everyone, it doesn't become original anymore. And there's a reason why these aren't seeing theaters. There's a reason why it's only on streaming. And there's a reason why audience score is on the fucking garbage bin with a lot of these films. Number 8, another one where their writing was absolutely atrocious. End of the Road, a Netflix film with Queen Latifah and Ludacris. I just don't know what to say. The writing. This is one of the ones where it's like, there's a Nazi around every corner. We're in Arizona. There's a Nazi there. There's a Nazi around this corner. Oh, let's go in the valley. What's behind this rock? Oh, another Nazi. Oh, who's in this hotel room? Oh my God, another Nazi. It's like, I think there's a total of 3,000. Like, I want, like, people that are saying, like KKK members as well as, like, 3,000 in the United States right now or something, like, so minuscule. I swear to God, Queen Latifah found 15% of them just sitting in the Arizona desert. Fuck if I know, man. Number 7 on the list, House of Darkness. And I think this is funny because on one of my comment sections for this one, someone's like, oh, you're going to an incel page. It's like, bro, I don't know you. You probably never watched this film. You're not probably one of those people that watched 237 films and know that this film was just like Mid-Century, was just like I Came By, was just like The Takedown, was just like, you know, most films, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, they all have the same fucking script and same buzzwords, just like you. You went on the internet, you said, oh, what's the buzzword of 2022? Incel. Which first I thought, I was thinking, oh, you're calling me a terrorist? From like, you know. So I was really confused where that one first came by because literally I'm not on Twitter ever. I don't really look at these buzzwords anymore. But it was just like, no, seriously. House of Darkness was literally taking Justin's Long character and making him like a bad guy, like purposely. Like, he comes in nice and everything, but all of a sudden at the very end, he's like, I want to fuck bitches. I want to have orgies with all the sisters. You're like, yo, what the fuck happened? Like, you were not like this in the beginning of the film. Like, it was just like purposely making Justin Long look like a fucking dick. And it's just like, I don't know. And it was the whole thing of like, oh, if a man did something bad in the 1800s, all men are bad. And you're just like, that was over 100 years ago. And it's Justin Long's fault? Like, what the fuck? House of Darkness, horrific. Tremendously awful. Yes, tremendously awful is what I'm saying now. Number six was another movie that probably no one's heard of, Cosmic Dawn. This is something about drugs and then, like, aliens. That's all I'm going to say. It was about drugs and aliens. I really don't remember this film, but I remember reading the synopsis again and thinking about this film. And I was like, this is trash. This is fucking garbage. This doesn't make zero sense. The characters, what they're doing, make zero sense. The ending, I'm just like, what the fuck is this? It was unleveled. It was uneven. It made no sense. This is one of the ones where it had ambition, but you're just like, the ambition went nowhere, and I don't know what the overall message of this movie was. Number five on this list is a movie because it's from the directors of Crank, one of them, Panama, with Mel Gibson and Cole Hazner, if I'm saying his last name right. The scouting in this movie, the acting in this movie, the action of this movie was atrocious. If you're trying to say a base is Nellis Air Force Base in the desert, you do not have a scouting location where there are trees, lush trees everywhere. Yes, there could be some palm trees, but what I'm seeing, like oak and other trees at Nellis Air Force Base, no. It is a ranch-style base. It is elongated. Nellis is called Area 51 for a reason. There's 51 areas. So when you have this being Nellis Air Force Base, it was laughable. Laughable is also is with a guy with a gun running away from a guy with no gun. What's laughable is this ATV / dirt bike race when it felt like they were going 7 miles an hour, which is atrocious when you have the director of Crank, which doing that crazy fucking sweet rollerblade scene in that first and second movie, then you go to this, oh my god, it was horrible. And when they're in the casino, it just felt like they're in the random living room of a random house. It was horrible. The set productions, everything about this just should not have been made whatsoever. It was very laughable and very bad. All right, number four on this list is Cheaper by the Dozen. Okay, this was a Disney Plus straight to streaming, and there's a reason why. It was horrible. I mean, when you open up with, I understand that this is probably California, because when I was living in California too, it felt like everyone had to put political symbols in their windows, and they did the same thing here. It, like I said, it was the writing. The writing is atrocious. It was just like victimhood, victims, victims. I'm a victim. I'm a victim. I'm a victim. And there was no humor in this whatsoever. It was horrible. Heinously horrible. And it this is propaganda. This is the definition of propaganda. Thank God no one saw it. Thank you, baby Jesus. No one saw Cheaper by the Dozen. Number three was a Peacock film called They, Them with Kevin Bacon. Woof! Woof! I should have known by the stench of They, Them, it was going to be the wokiest woke of the wokest woke. And this was woke of the fucking woke. They made this movie saying, let's check off every diversity box. And this is where we're going with today, is diversity. I hate that word now, because you know what? Yeah, you could have diversity and not be so forceful with it. People act like diversity never happened. Look at the movies from the 90s. I could pull out so many fucking movies from the 90s where there was diversity galore. But the problem is, we are so stamping on it now of, we need that, we need it, we need it. But when you actually open your eyes and look what happened in the 80s, 90s, and 2000s, there was a shit ton of movies with diversity that just people didn't notice. And now all of a sudden we're like, oh, this is a new thing. No, it's because people have done it and just said, this is normal, this is life. There's 17% of this population in America, so let's make it 17% in the film. now it's overblown where it's just like, that's not diversity. You're just making shit up all of a sudden. And they, them, does that same thing of checking every single fucking box, but it doesn't help that the acting was atrocious, the writing atrocious, everything about it was laughable. There was no horror elements. The story made no fucking sense. The whole thing was just like a conversion camp, and it was laughable. If you saw They, Them, it is on your bottom 10. And I have seen this movie on multiple people's bottom 10. Number 2 is another one that's on a lot of people's bottom 10. The Bubble. Yes, The Bubble was that bad. This is an over 2-hour movie about actors and influencers. I don't know if they're trying to make fun of actors or not, but it was horrible. Nothing about this movie was funny. Random dance sequences. I don't know what the whole point of this movie was. I truly don't know. And when you have a movie like this trying to make fun of actors, but you kind of don't, it's just like, what are we doing? I just don't know how Judd Apatow can still make movies like this. He made this, Train Wreck. He needs to stop. Like, he produced Bros. Like, I don't know what this movie was supposed to be. I don't know how Netflix said, you know what, we're still going to release it. They probably said, fuck, we lost a shit ton of money with this film, and so we're just going to put it on streaming service. And my God, this movie is one of the worst of 2022. Bubble would be the worst of 22, actually, when I think about it. But this movie, out of Sundance, number 1, We Met in Virtual Reality. So I was just thinking, did this get a release? Actually, it was released on HBO Max in May. I fucking hated this movie with a fucking passion. Oh my God. This movie normalizes this culture of doing lap dances in the VR world, not being outside in the real world. I mean, yes, there might be some good elements in this film of like, okay, teaching sign language. But when I see someone do sign language in the virtual reality world, it's not fluent. So you're just going to guess what they're doing. And I just feel like this is forcing people to be in that metaverse bubble, which, thank God, like, they shut down a lot of that metaverse shit for Facebook because it crashed and fucking burned. Thank God they realized this. So this VR world, I understand if you want to be in it for like an hour a fucking week and just be like, yo, what's up, bro? I haven't seen you in a couple of weeks, and it'll be a fun thing. But when people are on this every day of the fucking week for hours at a time, doing random lap dances, doing drag queen stuff, doing just shit that is fucking propaganda, shit that is fucking just disgusting. This is forcing people to not be sociable in the real world. This is forcing like the mass culture of kids having mental disorders. And it is true. Look at it. Look at the studies of what states are losing in fucking math, science. And this could correlate to it because we are forcing people to live in the pod, eat the bugs. And this movie forcefully fucking does it. It disgusts me. This movie is horrible. It forces people to go, hey, what if I like, and they're like, oh, let's go through Jurassic Park. You know what you could do instead? Go into a real fucking car and go hiking, go camping, do something in the real fucking world. And some people are like, oh, what if they can't? I'm pretty sure most of these people can. Yes, some people might not be able to. Yeah, the crazy almost 1%. I know for a fact when my sister had cancer, I was in a fucking wheelchair, she had a chance and she did go to Lourdes, France. So you don't have the fucking audacity to tell me, oh, I can't go camping because I'm gluten-free. Fuck off and live your life in the real fucking world, because there's real people fucking out there. Fuck off with this worst movie of the fucking year. So, yep, that is my top 10 worst movies of 2022. It is what it is. How many of them have you seen? Chase Hawk with the Blue Futon. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know if you think it's Blue Futonutopia. You Blue Futonian. Thank you for watching. Have a fantastic day. Let's just hope 2023 isn't this bad.